Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolo Tech, and today Apple released iOS 15.1 Beta 4. This is available to developers, and usually by the time this video is live, you'll see the public beta as well. With Beta 3 last week, we did have it by the time I made this video live, so hopefully it's out now. If not, give it a little while, or it will be out tomorrow. Now this came in at 676.4 megabytes. That's similarly sized on all the devices here, the iPhone 11, 12 Pro Max, 6S Plus, and iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.1 Beta 4, watchOS 8.1 Beta 4, tvOS 15.1 Beta 4, and macOS Monterey Beta 10. 10 betas with macOS Monterey. Hopefully we'll see a final release for that very soon. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, go to General, then About. And as you can see, the build number is 19B5068A. We're finally to an A build, which means we're very close to a final release usually. Typically when we have an A build, it means we'll have a release candidate soon with a final version, maybe as soon as next week. We'll talk more about that in a little while. Now, the first new thing is a modem update. On the 13 Pro Max, we go from 1.15.01 to 1.15.02 for the modem update. So there is an update there. And as far as new features, well, in 15.1, it brings a bunch of new features. But with Beta 4, there's only a few small changes that I've noticed so far. And thanks to Braden for helping me out with some of these. But the first thing is I got a new splash screen the first time I opened the Home app. And you'll see it just says control your home, set it and forget it, and share access. So that was a new screen, as well as a new screen on the podcast app. So if we go into Apple's own podcast app, you can see it says welcome to your library. There's shows, saved, and latest episodes. And then you can hit continue and get to your main screen or your library. So those were the major changes in this. However, with 15.1, we do gain share playback. We also gain screen sharing while using FaceTime, as well as ProRes, Apple ProRes in the camera app. That was with Beta 3. They finally added that. Under formats, we have ProRes with the iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max. And there's also an option to switch off macro. So all of those things are in 15.1, along with probably a few more things as well. So as far as anything new, really the splash screens are the main thing, along with pretty much some bug fixes that they haven't mentioned. Now, as far as universal control with the iPad, that's something we've been waiting for quite some time. Universal control still is not here. Universal control will allow us to use a trackpad or a mouse to go between an iPad and maybe a Mac that we have or a couple different screens. And so far it's not available. It's not in the settings anywhere. And before, if you went to AirPlay and handoff, turned off handoff, turned it back on, you would have a little icon here or another little selection box that would tell you about maybe using universal control. But so far, it's not available, it's not in the notes, and it's not in the notes of macOS Monterey. So we haven't seen anything about that. So as far as new features, that's everything. Not a whole lot new as we get closer to the final version of iOS 15.1, but there are some resolved and known issues. As far as resolved issues specifically though, there are none mentioned that are new in the notes. And the same is true with known issues. Most of them are the same as before. There are 6 known issues in iOS 15.1 Beta 4, and some of those are the same as before, where you could have a loss of audio during calls, followed by the call being dropped in some conditions, and Apple says to fix that to toggle on and off airplane mode. So that's what they've said to fix that issue. Also, if you're using accessibility with voice control and you're trying to set an alarm, that still may not work properly in the clock app. Also, Matter accessory notifications for home still may not work properly. So all of the things that were there with Beta 3 are still there according to Apple. Now, as far as the storage bug, where people are either seeing an excessive amount of storage being used, or maybe the phone telling them they have more storage available than they really do, it looks like the issue is still there with Beta 4. It was there with iOS 15.0.2 that Apple released the other day, and people are still seeing it. On iPhone storage, if we go into storage, you'll see currently I'm using 90 gigabytes of 256 gigabytes, and you'll see this looks pretty normal. However, if you go down to the bottom, some people are seeing huge amounts of data being used for system data. 27.98 gigabytes is a lot. this may shrink over time as it finishes processing in the background, but there's definitely an excessive use for some people and also showing more storage than you actually have available. Apple has not mentioned that they've fixed anything else in this update. Now, once the final version comes out, we'll know exactly what's fixed, as they'll tell us in the notes for that. But right now we don't know of anything specific as far as that goes. Now, as far as overall battery life, well, I just switched back to the iPhone 13 Pro Max. I was using the 13 Pro for about a week, getting about 6 to 7 hours of screen on time on beta one. And today I can only show you my usage for today, since I've been using this for today and it's a brand new phone. So battery health should be 100%, but you'll see it only has the button for the last 24 hours. And so we have 2 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 58 minutes of screen off time, and I have 74% left. That's pretty good considering I switched everything over, restored everything, updated this, and switched all of my data to this. So it's processing a lot in the background, and so far it's doing pretty good. So we'll give it a few days, and I would expect battery to be about the same. Some people were having excellent battery life on beta 3, others were not. I found it to be okay on the newer phones, but again, some people had poor battery life. When it comes to battery life on the iPad, it was a different story. So with the iPad, if we go into settings and we go to my battery here, you can see that I had 1 hour and 53 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 28 minutes of screen off time. I'm not using this with the screen off. There's definitely an issue there. The same is true there. 12 hours of screen off time. I find I have to charge this an awful lot, and something's using the battery quite a bit that shouldn't be. So there's definitely an issue on the iPad for me. I can try resetting the settings again, but I think there's just something being run in the background that we wouldn't typically expect. Now, as far as performance overall, I've already had people tell me that it seems to be a little bit smoother. Now, on the newer phone, you'll probably not notice too much of a difference, but if we go maybe to an iPhone 6S Plus and take a look at that, it should be about the same as well. This is the first time scrolling through since I updated, and as I scroll through, it seems to be nice and smooth. If we go into, let's try music. Music takes a second to load, but it's still, again, very smooth. And if we go into Minecraft, let's try that. It actually loaded fairly quickly. It's a little bit choppy here, but let's go ahead and hit play. We'll just go to my world here and let it load, and we'll give it just a moment. So it just finished loading. It probably took between 40 and 50 seconds to load, but it just finished and it seems to be fairly smooth. And the last time I tried this, it was a bit choppy at first and took a long, long time. Now it seems to be nice and smooth. The phone is getting a little bit warm in the back, and it wasn't warm right after updating. So the heat of the phone seems to be improved this time around, and the phone cooled down nice and quickly. And I think we can also see that with the Geekbench scores. Now, I ran Geekbench 5 on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, and as you can see, it scored 1,720 for single core, 4,670 for multi-core. Now, I did run this twice, and you can see the two different scores here. It's actually a little bit lower for single core and a little bit lower for multi-core. However, it does feel a little bit faster. So it could improve after the next few days or after the next few hours, but there was an improvement on other devices here. So let's go ahead and take a look at all of them. Now on the left, we have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021. Then we have the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 11, and then the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now, what's different between these is the middle two, or older devices, actually have better scores than the previous time from beta 3 to beta 4. But the iPad or the iPhone 13 Pro Max actually have slightly lower scores. So there's some differences going on there. It shouldn't make too much of a difference, but it is something worth noting since it does seem to be nice and fast on older devices as well. So that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.1 beta 4? Well, if you wanted to try the beta out just to see what it's like, maybe try out SharePlay for yourself, or maybe screen sharing during FaceTime, you could do that. However, I wouldn't recommend it to try and gain battery life or something like that. I typically don't recommend betas trying to improve something that's not working properly in the public release for you. I would wait for the final release of that. And I would expect iOS 15.1 probably as soon as next week. Now, I know we don't have a release candidate. Apple has pushed those out as soon as Friday, and then maybe a final after the event that we have. We have an event on October 18th where we'll see Mac maybe M1X products, things like that. I talked about in a video yesterday, and I would expect maybe a final release somewhere in this week, along with maybe macOS Monterey as well. Since we haven't seen that yet, and Apple is going to introduce new Mac products, I would expect something like that with this following week, where we'll have a bunch of different OS updates, and then we'll move on to maybe iOS 15.2 and beyond. So that's what I'm really expecting, is maybe something as soon as next week. However, if not, we should have a release candidate within a week, and then maybe a final release the following week. But I really think it will be next week based on what they've done in the past. So that's everything with iOS 15.1 Beta 4. Of course, I'll be using it on my main device. And if you'd like a follow-up, let me know in the comments below. I typically do those on the weekend just to see how it's going overall. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.